This is how I was able to accept, let go, and set myself free. I realized that I, Cole Hastings, do not exist, and you don't either. So what do I mean by this? Well, I guess I would have to take you back to the day that I was first born. Look at that cute little guy. Okay, this actually truly is not me, it's just some stock footage of a baby, but pretend that's me in baby form. From the day I came out of my mother's womb, I was declared to be Cole Hastings. But doesn't that seem a little too ambiguous? What about before I was conceived, still in my mother's womb? Was I still Cole Hastings? Or was I Cole Hastings when I won the fight to the egg as a tiny little sperm? Before this turns into an argument about pro-choice versus pro-life, let me just continue the point I'm actually trying to make. So after I was born, I then grew up into a healthy little kid. I was able to form semi-coherent thoughts with my now semi-developed brain thanks to all of the English language I had learned so far. And so, because of that, I adopted certain characteristics. I was pretty weird and I loved to hang out with my shirt off. I screamed a lot and I was pretty wild. Well, actually, that just sounds like any regular kid. What really separated me from others is what I developed interests in. I really liked to draw and create art. I liked cup stacking. I liked to create skits with my friends. I had crushes on certain types of girls. I remember the first girl I ever had a crush on was one that I played soccer with. And I remember the first time I ever felt like I lost someone I cared about when I kept calling the house of a girl in my 7th grade homeroom class and she lost interest in me. My interests shaped my attitudes towards myself in life, and my attitudes shaped my interests. Eventually, the culmination of everything I had done so far and the stories that composed my life formed themselves into who I am, Cole Hastings. But here's where we have to go back to that first question that I asked. Am I still Cole Hastings? Or am I even more of Cole Hastings than I was back then when I was first conceived? If you aren't aware already, your brain doesn't actually stop developing until you're around 25. So can you really even call yourself whatever name you've been given and what you've attached to that if your brain isn't even fully developed yet? And those things that you've attached to your name are also quite unclear. Humans have a pretty terrible memory when it comes to remembering exactly what we've done. I bet the majority of you can't even tell me what you had for breakfast last week, let alone most of the things that you've done in your life thus far. We can see this explicitly when victims accidentally identify the wrong person in a group of suspects when they're positive they've got the right person. The truth is, who we are is a hazy misrepresentation of an illusion of our past selves. And you really only know who you are in relation to others. People have created definitions and ideas of who you are based on that past rendition of yourself. If you asked my mom who I was, this is what she would say.
Very intelligent, creative, and he's on his own path. Handsome!
I think she's a little biased.
If you asked my friends who I was, this is what they would say.
It's tough to answer right on the spot because since I've known you for so long and you've made somewhat of a drastic change in the last couple of years, my brain kind of puts you in like two different parts, you know what I'm saying? The Cole from like the past for some reason that's like still there, and then modern day Cole, which is the same person but quite different.
So, which one is right? Their opinions of who I am are partly due to what they know about me, what they've seen me done, and how I act around them, but everybody morphs themselves at least a little bit to who they hang around. With some of my friend groups, I become a little rowdy, and then with other friend groups, I'm nice and quiet and calm and relaxed. And just because I could be characterized by most of what these people have said about me in the past, doesn't mean that's who I am right now. It's easy to say that all of that was me because I still encapsulate the same bag of skin. But wait, not even that's true because your skin regenerates every 27 days or so. Even your bones regenerate every 10 years. So, just who the hell are you? The truth is, this is an impossible question to answer. Because every time you try to answer it, the answer changes and it can never be fully reached. Whoever you think you are doesn't actually exist. When some people come to this conclusion, they start to go a bit mad because one of our most basic biological needs is the need for consistency. We are all creatures of habit. And when we can't identify a consistent image of our environment, but especially ourselves, this can lead to feelings of depersonalization. This is something that I have talked about struggling with previously on my channel. It's like looking at yourself in the world from a third-person view and you feel so detached from reality. I was still trying to grab onto the labels, beliefs, stories, and ideas that I had previously attached to my existence to try and understand it. That is, until I reached a breaking point. And that is when I just surrendered. I realized that there was nothing to find, and what you're searching for, you already have. And with this surrendering that I went through, it caused the exact opposite reaction of a depersonalization experience where you feel so detached from reality, where instead, I felt connected to everything. When certain people come to these realizations, they may have the sudden urge to quit their jobs and live in a forest for the rest of their lives. And while that's totally acceptable and understandable, what I chose to do was exactly what I've always done. There are many benefits to this way of living. Firstly, you stop putting labels on yourself, and in return, it's much easier to let go of things. Labels are our way of creating a consistent image of ourselves in order to fit in with a certain group and have some sort of grip on who we think we are. But when you start to label yourself, what comes with that are the biases and tendencies associated with that label. And with that comes a lot of unnecessary baggage. Imagine with each label you put on yourself, you're attaching a 5-pound weight somewhere on your body. For example, you could say you're a Democrat, a follower of this religion, an introvert, etc. So what happens when someone tries to argue against your labels, or you yourself break the characteristics or rules that are attached to these labels that you identify with? The weight of these labels start to crush you, and you feel threatened. And in return, you go through a lot of unnecessary suffering. I used to tell myself in a lot of situations, this is just the way I am. I am this, and I am this. Which is the same thing as saying, I am the stories that other people and the voice inside my head tells me I am. But many of these stories that come from a past version of yourself, whoever that was, do more harm than good. Now, I try not to label myself as anything. I'm not a bodybuilder. I'm not an alpha male or a sigma male. I'm not a Democrat. I'm not a Republican. I'm just this, whatever that may be in a given moment. And as a result, I no longer beat myself up too much for past mistakes. I no longer get too affected by rejection or failure. I can get through heartbreaks much easier. And people's negativity towards me has much less of an effect on me. Because there is no me that can be offended or heartbroken or rejected. This is the reason that people feel so bad when they fall asleep later than usual or they fall out of their goals. Because when you do something that does not match up with who you think you are, so let's say when you fall asleep later than usual, which is what I did yesterday, you start to beat yourself up so much because you're saying, I am this very productive and always structured and always on time type of person. And you didn't just let yourself be whoever that was in the present moment. In that present moment, you wanted to stay up a little bit later than usual. But since you're way too heavily identified with the label of being a very structured, organized person, that falling asleep too late affects you more than it should. But let's be real here, I am still negatively impacted by these things sometimes. But when you start to realize this and really internalize this, you then become fluid. You understand that you are a constantly changing being, unbound by the restrictions of labels, and you go throughout your life allowing yourself to become presentness. And that makes you become pretty much limitless in what you're capable of achieving and doing because you can let go of things so much easier. When you start to shift your way of living to this way and not attach to things or your thoughts too greatly, you go throughout life with this intense feeling of joy created by presentness. You stop thinking that you are your thoughts. You are the observer of your thoughts, and your thoughts thereby have less of a hold or effect on you, just like labels. And you stop thinking you are a culmination of the past. You dispel the illusion of the past and future, and you simply just be. You might be thinking to yourself, Cole, when it comes to being fluid and just being in the present moment, what if your present moment you is lazy and unmotivated and generally just a bad person? Well, almost anyone that has been feeling that way for a long time is still too heavily attached to their habitual thought patterns and past identification. Because humans aren't naturally lazy and uninspired all the time. And humans aren't naturally cruel to others and themselves. You've been diseased with a bad program created by your past, which I've talked about in a previous video. When you shed your ego and become presentness, you'll naturally want to do things and accomplish things that are good for this vessel in which you encapsulate. But with that being said, consuming the right information and being in a positive environment with the right people can definitely help you get there. And then there's this question of how can we possibly go on living the same way we are now when we realize that we don't exist? How can one possibly achieve what I'm talking about while still choosing to partake in the modern world? Well, it's pretty simple. You just decide to keep playing the game by letting people call you by your name and who they believe you are and doing the things you do, but without all of those layers you previously had on. But at the end of the day, if what I'm saying causes you to have an existential crisis and freak out, just remember this. Don't take anything I say too seriously. Now, a lot of you are probably wondering, Cole, how do you keep your mind so sharp so you can express these types of thoughts to us? Well, I always keep a sense of curiosity and a love for learning with me, and a great way to do that is using the sponsor of today's video, which is Brilliant. Brilliant is an online learning platform for STEM that replaces lecture videos with hands-on, interactive lessons. No matter what age you are or what skill level you're at, I'm sure they have a STEM-related field that has an incredible way to learn it. Take, for example, this Algorithm Fundamentals course. All throughout this course, you can solve these coding challenges by shifting around blocks of pseudocode and getting immediate feedback. As many of you know, I took computer science in college, and I think it's such an important skill to have in your arsenal just due to how important it's going to be for the future, and the way they teach you about how to program decision making with actionable, interactive steps was more comprehensible than any computer science course I took in college. The real-time feedback with the questions they had me answer and the explanations they give me for each answer is such a practical way to learn. So if you are interested in expanding your knowledge in these fields and improving your ability to think, then you can go to the link in my description. And the first 200 people to sign up will get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Thank you to all the patrons on this channel on Patreon. If you don't know what this is, it's a platform separate from YouTube where I'm putting out exclusive videos and podcasts you can't find anywhere else. You can also talk to me one-on-one over there. If you want to check that out, the link is in the description, patreon.com/ColeHastings. Thank you guys so much for watching. Whoever you are that is watching this, and see you guys later.